Hello everyone, this is Zahur Malhotra from SFDC Stop, and in this video we are going to learn that how we can make a lightning component to view a record in just 5 minutes. Yes, you heard it right, we can make a lightning component from scratch to view a single record in Salesforce in just 5 minutes. Salesforce has launched a lot of new tags, and I am going to demonstrate those tags one by one in this tutorial series. So this is the first tutorial in Salesforce Lightning Tags tutorial series, in which we are going to use lightning column record view form tag, and we are going to make a lightning component from scratch that will display a whole record in 5 minutes. So let's get started. Our time starts now. So first of all, we are going to create a new lightning application so that we can test our component, and I am going to name this app as lightning record view form app, or I should say lightning record view app. That's okay. And I'm clicking on submit. So my app is ready. And in this app, I'm going to extend force SLDS. And I'm going to call lightning component, that is lightning record view CMP. And in this lightning component, I am going to pass a record ID. So I am just taking the record ID of a contact to pass in this. So let's take any contact like this, and I am going to take its record ID, and I am going to pass in it. Record ID. Okay, so I have to make a lightning component first. Let's go to new lightning component. And my lightning component name is lightning record view CMP, and let's make it available for lightning page, lightning record page, lightning tab. Okay, so my lightning app is ready. I'm going to save that, and here's where I can preview my app. And in the lightning component, I have to make the changes now. So let's move on to our lightning component and let's see what we can do. Okay, so in our lightning component, first of all, I am going to use lightning record view form tag. So lightning record view form, and in this lightning record view form, there are mainly two parameters that I have to pass. One is the record ID, and as I am passing the record ID from my application, so I am going to use that record ID. And I have already implemented force colon has record ID, using which we can refer to record ID using its record ID name. So in the record ID, I'm going to give v dot record ID, and then I'm going to add object API name. This is basically the name of the object that we are going to use to display the fields. So object API name is contact, as I am going to pass a contact ID here, and within this I am going to use a lightning card just for display. So lightning card, I am going to give a title, that is, let's say, contact details. And within this lightning card, I am going to make a card body, and to make a card body, I am going to use P and then SLDS. Class is equal to SLDS hyphen P hyphen horizontal underscore small. So within this body, I'm going to make a div with SLDS grid, so that I can divide this body into two equal parts. And within this grid, I'm going to make two equal parts. First is SLDS call, then SLDS colon size, SLDS size underscore 1 hyphen of hyphen 2, and I'm going to complete that div, and I'm going to copy and paste the same div again. So our structure is ready, and in this I just have to implement the fields. So first field I'm going to use is lightning output field. And the field name is I am going to give as, let's say, first name. I have to give the API name here for the field, so I am giving it as first name. And I am going to repeat this tag 3 times here and 3 times here so that I can have a good looking form. So first name of contact, and I can take last name of contact. Apart from this, I can take mobile phone. And what I have another of contact, we have I think the account ID. And I think now we have department. And apart from that, I have, let's say, birth date. So that's all, guys. I think we have made our Lightning component. Let's test it out. Okay, so in the birth date, there is an issue, I think. Birth date. I don't know whether I have a birth date in my contact or not. So let's check the enter details. Yes, the birth date column is empty. So let's add a date here. The birth date is 2nd April and click on save. I'm going to refresh my component. Okay, so my component is ready within 5 minutes. I have my contact details component, that is a Lightning card in which I have my first name, last name, mobile phone, account ID, department, as well as the birth date, which is the same, that is their first name, last name, mobile phone, account ID, my department, internal operations, and the date here. So let's understand this, that what we did right now within this 5 minutes, what we did to implement this thing. First of all, I have created a Lightning application in which I extends the SLDS class so that I can use the Lightning design system. And then I called the Lightning record view component, which I have made here. And I have passed the record ID of a contact, which we need to show. So in the Lightning record view component, I have simply extended, or I can say implements, certain features so that I can implement my component in Lightning tab and other places. And the main thing to focus here is I have implemented force colon has record ID. So what is force colon has record ID do? It, you can say that it creates a hidden Lightning, you can say, attribute using which we can get the record ID. So force colon has record ID has created a hidden attribute. It's like aura attribute that we make, and name is record ID. So this attribute is already made when we use this attribute. Okay, so this attribute is already made when we use force colon has record ID in our application. So our force colon has record ID has already made this attribute, and it automatically takes the record ID from the page under which this component is embedded. Right now I haven't embedded in this component in any page, so I am passing the record ID attribute and ID from my application. So this record ID attribute is getting the ID of the contact, and this record ID attribute is used to pass the record ID to my Lightning record view form. Lightning record view form is a simple tag using which we can display a Lightning form for any record without using an FX controller. So you just have to pass a record ID and an object API name in Lightning record view form. So the record ID I have picked up from v.recordID, that is my attribute. And the object API name I have given it as contact, because I am going to use the contact fields, and the record ID is also of a contact. So within this, I have generally used Lightning card that I have used before in my previous videos too. We just have to give a title and we can give a body. So in the title, I have given contact details that we are getting here. And in the body of the card, I have simply used SLDS classes first to make a paragraph. This is a standard, you can say, syntax that is given in the Salesforce documentation. That in the body, I have to give P class is equal to SLDS-P-horizontal_small. And within this body, I have first created an SLDS grid so that I can divide this body into two equal columns. And then I have given two equal columns. This is the first column and this is the second column. And then I have used Lightning colon output field. This is another tag by Salesforce which we can use in the forms like Lightning colon record view form. And this output field just take the field name that we are going to display here. And this field name should be the API name. Remember, where in the object API name also it is a API name, and in the field name also it is a API name. So but the API name of my contact, if I see, let's move on to edit object. And if I go to contact, then the API name of first name, here the account name has an API name account ID, similarly the birth date has an API name birth date, and the account you can say first name, I should say, yeah, we can use name also, but we can use first name too, it is not visible here, but we can use that. So the API name of the field should be there. And if I am using a custom field, suppose if I have to use account number, then I should use the API name of that, and it will be embedding underscore underscore C also. Like if I use here account number, and if I refresh this page, then account number is there, which is of my contact Andy Young. I can check out the account number here. And remember, when I use a custom field, I have embedded a underscore underscore C, which is already there in the API name. Okay. So in the similarly in the object API name also, if I'm using custom object, then it must be having underscore underscore C at the end, so don't forget to remember that. So in the Lightning output field, we just have to give the API name of our fields, and our data will be populated automatically as Lightning output field, go into its parent and check for the record ID, and if there is any valid record ID, it automatically populates the fields that are associated with that record. So this is all for this video. I think we have done our job and we have made a Lightning record view form, that is a form to view the Lightning record in just 5 minutes. For other components also, it also supports custom objects and custom fields. So if you want to use custom object, feel free to use that. And I should say that's all for now. I think we have made a Lightning component. And yes, one thing I also want to tell you, that I can embed this component and in my page, and there is a difference when I embed this component. So I'm going to edit page, and my component name was Lightning record view CMP. So let's search for Lightning record view component, and I'm going to embed it in my contact page here. And I'm going to save this, and I'm going back. So one thing I want to tell you, that if you remember in any contact, like if I have a contact here, Andy Young, then the account ID in my contact, that is account name, it is a lookup, right? So my form is even displaying the lookup field also, but it is giving only text. But if you embed this component in any actual page, like I have embedded this component in the Andy Young contact page, then it is giving the actual link to the account. So if I click on this, I get onto my account. So it also supports the lookup field. That's an awesome thing. And automatically formats the data according to you. Like if I have a mobile number and I click on this, then you can see the URL here. Then it will directly call my number. And the birth date field is also formatted automatically. So all the formatting, everything is done by Salesforce for you. So that's all for record view form and this video, guys. Thanks for watching. And for all the code, you can visit my GitHub repository, Salesforce Lightning Tags tutorial. And for the upcoming tags also, I will add all the code in this single repository. And here I have added Lightning record view app and Lightning record view CMP data. And there are a lot of tags that are introduced by Salesforce, and I am going to take those tags one by one and teach you about that. So thanks for watching this video. And recently, today even, I have created my page for SFDC Stop YouTube and blog. So if you want to get latest updates and if you want to stay updated, you can go there and you can like this page. Okay guys, so see you in the next video. Thanks for watching, and do comment your feedback on this, and do comment in your use cases where you are going to implement this. Okay, have a good day. Bye bye.